So it's always fun to bust out a tune on a guitar that nobody expects you to play. And the best thing about this song, you can play it fast, you can play it slow, any tempo, it works either way. Let me show you. Spin Me Round Like a Record by Dead or Alive. What a great, great song. Not really one you'd think for an acoustic guitar. It's got quite a few elements to it, and I'm going to break down each of those, you know, pretty quickly for you right now. It's got a verse, a chorus, a bridge, an instrumental, and an outro, of course. Let's start with that verse. Now, the song starts on an E minor, and it's between an E minor and an A. Now, I add a bit more depth to that by doing an E minor seventh variant, and then an A and an A seventh variant. Now, I'm going to put the chord patterns on the screen there because, yeah, I'm left-handed and I'm playing on a right-hand strung guitar, which means these finger patterns will look upside down to most of you. But, hey, you got the same challenge as me. Just get these, get your fretting fingers in the right place and play along. Now, this verse, right? So let me just do a demo for you in slowish tempo right now. So it just starts with...
Get to know your name. And if I
get the idea, so I'm playing the E minor, and then I'm just lifting my pointer finger off that D string for that E minor seventh variant, I suppose. Off, on, off, transition to the A. A7, off, E minor. A7, A. And then we transition straight into the pre-chorus.
All I know is that to me you look like you're not
right, so pretty simple again, E minor, but you know, what am I doing to add a bit more depth and variety to the song? I'm just focusing on strumming those bass strings on this one. All I know is that to me, to a G, you look like you're lots of fun. A, open up your loving arms. B, watch out, here I come. Then you can go straight into the chorus. So the chorus has two parts, right? An E minor, G, A, and an E minor, G, A, B. Let's do it. Spin me right round, A, E minor, like a record, baby. A, B, E minor, G, A, E minor, A, B, E. And of course, you don't have to do the open chords down here for the A and the B. You can do them on the 5th fret and the 7th fret in a bar chord form, right? Whatever works for you, they both sound cool. Hey folks, if this sort of music is your thing on guitar, then you'll definitely want to check out my new songbook. It features the best songs from all of my YouTube tutorials in the first year. All of them sound great around a campfire, so check out the link in the description below and you will have an instant song repertoire. So hey folks, I always like to tell you a few fun facts about the song. This one released in 1985, of course by Dead or Alive, which was a British synth pop band at the time, headed by their flamboyant, you know, frontman Pete Burns, right? Known for his big hair, his occasional eye patch, and his, you know, his stage presence. He certainly owned the crowd when he was out there performing. Now, a little bit of controversy about the recording of the song. At the time, Dead or Alive engaged Stock, Aitman and Waterman, who were a, you know, fairly new production team at the time in the UK. Those of you that know the UK music scene in the 80s, that production trio went on to do massive, massive things, producing mega hits all around the place. But that aside, in the recording studio for this song, there was nothing but friction, all right? The band wanted this, the producers wanted that, they clashed heads, and at the end of the day, well, you know, magic happened, of course, because this song went on to become a number one in the UK, a number 11 in the US billboards, and here in Australia, it hit number five. So it was a very successful, commercially successful song. And it's not hard to see why. It's really catchy. And, you know, believe it or not, it's great on acoustic guitar. So make sure you put this one in your repertoire. And don't forget, folks, I do a free song sheet for every one of my lessons. The link is below. It's got the chords, the lyrics, everything you need to know how to learn, practice, and play this song. All right, the last two components is that little instrumental break and the bridge. Now, the instrumental break, again, it's all based around the E minor, but in this case, I'm doing the bar chord on the 7th fret, the E minor bar chord. A couple of quick down strums. Down, down, down. Then you transition to the D on the 5th fret. Down two frets to the C on the 3rd fret. To a B minor 2nd fret. To an A minor. Back to a B. Let's do this in real time. Back to the chorus and I. Now, the other one is the bridge. I want your love. Same chords again. It's just how you play them, all right? So, I want... So, E minor. I want your... Bass. G. Whoa, whoa. A. Up to the B.
I want your... E minor. G. A.
B. And then we go back to that pre-chorus.
Said to me, you look like you're lots of fun. Open up your loving arms, watch out, here I come.
So you can mix up all those elements, but that's the basic building blocks of this song. Do it however you like. Now, you know, on YouTube and Spotify, there's many people that sing it super slow, like a lounge room ballad, or they sing it high tempo, techno, you know, dance floor version. It doesn't matter which one, whatever you do the one that's comfortable for you. My playthrough, I did a bit of an in-between, not quite slow, not quite fast, somewhere in between, just like Goldilocks. Well, let's have a quick look at the strumology to this song. The verse, it's got a few different strumming patterns, or a couple of different strumming patterns. Let's start with that verse, where it's a nice gentle down, 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 up, up, down, down.
Oh,
course, when you move to the chorus, you're just going to throw a little up strums to add a bit more funk to it, all right? So it's the same bass pattern, but it'll sound a bit like this. Now, that might be a lot to take in. Honestly, my belief in strumming is just close your eyes and feel the song, all right? You don't need to look at all these letters I'm putting on the screen. All right? You know how the song goes, and you strum it how you feel it on the downbeats and that. So block the strings and just sing it in your head, and then just strum away like I'm doing there. Down, down. So a quick overview of the vocal ability to the song. Using my patented Patreon vocal ability rating system, I'd give this one a busker level rating. I think you need to have some sort of vocal chops, but you don't have to be an absolute rock star. But hey, if you really want a song that's easy to sing and easy to play and super popular amongst all the baby boomers and Gen Xers, then you definitely need to check out this one right here.